dear students, congratulations for being promoted to Standard 11. Hope you have collected your compulsory English textbook on Maharashtra State Board. Let me introduce you to the contents of your English textbook. There are four sections: Section 1 Prose, Section 2 Poetry, Section 3 Writing Skill, and Section 4 Drama. Dear students, you are students at the Plus 2 stage now. You need better sentence construction skills, appropriate vocabulary building and usage. You need to know how words take on new meanings according to the context. To enhance your competences, your English textbook has reinforced listening skill, speaking skill, reading skill, writing skill and study skill. The very first prose titled Being Neighbourly is an extract from a book titled Little Women. Little Women is written by an American writer of 19th century. She was born in 1832 and a renowned feminist writer. She had strong faith in women empowerment, and this writer's name is Louisa May Alcott. Louisa May Alcott wrote the book Little Women. Little Women has been a praiseworthy book among the readers of all generations. The setting of a book is the suburbs of Boston. There are some charming characters. There are four sisters: Meg, Joe, Beth and Amy. Their loving parents are there and their friend Lori. Each character is real and unique. Readers remain firmly with the sisters through all their joys, sorrows, struggles, conflicts, triumphs and so on. Their experiences in lives guide us in our lives phases too. This extract, Being Neighbourly, affords us a glimpse into the book. It narrates the beginning of a lifelong friendship between the most charming girl, Jo, and the wealthy new neighbor, Lori. It shows a good friendship between two families. I would like to read page number 2 now for you. Please, students, listen to me carefully. "What in the world are you going to do now, Jo?" asked Meg one snowy afternoon as her sister came tramping through the hall in rubber boots, old sack and hood, with a broom in one hand and a shovel in the other. "Going out for exercise," answered Jo with a mischievous twinkle in her eyes. "I should think two long walks this morning would have been enough. It's cold and dull out, and I advise you to stay warm and dry by the fire as I do," said Meg with a shiver. "Never take advice, can't keep still all day, and not being a pussycat. I don't like to doze by the fire. I like adventures, and I'm going to find some." Dear students, here we hear some conversations between two sisters, Meg and Jo. Jo is adventurous. She wishes to go out for exercises in cold winter, and Meg is advising her to stay warm and dry by the fire, as she does because there is shivering cold outside. Jo is not willing to obey her sister. She likes to go out. She does not like a cozy life. Well, some words may sound new to you. Well, you know, children, tramping means to tramp, means to stamp. Stamping her feet. Sack, S-A-C-Q-U-E, sack, short jacket, and hood. Hood means just a cover for head. Shovel, one sort of gardening instrument, and dozing means
to doze means to sleep lightly. So just I shall go for the page number 3rd reading and analysis in my next video. Thank you for your patient hearing. Bye.